Apostle Michael Akpo, Storm Yenagwa, by your South State with a two-day crusade. Team, Father, disappoint my enemy.
Inside the cage, your house, the same ministry will not be sweet. You are finding it problems,
yes,
problems,
sir. Yes, yes,
problems.
Sir. Yes, sir.
The more you pray, the more they attack you.
Yes, sir.
In the dream,
yes, sir.
They attack your prayer life.
Yes, sir.
Can I be free with you?
Yes, sir.
Stretch your hand up. Power, katabata seka. Stand up, stand up, stand up, stand up. How long have you been coming here?
I came today.
This is the first time.
Yes, sir.
So you are not here our latest. Say, so tell me your latest.
Sir.
Say, tell me your latest.
Tell me your latest.
Rapa Gotye.
Gotye.
Rapa Gotye.
Gotye. Gotye.
Date, 1st and 2nd December 2017. Time, Friday 1st, 4 p.m. Saturday 2nd, 7 a.m. and 4 p.m.
Venue, Bansia School Fit, opposite Vegas, Bansia Yenagwa, Bayel South State, Nigeria.
Yenagwa, Bayel South State, Nigeria.
2097
is coming. Unusual Grace stormed the land of Sapler with a two-day crusade. 2 days, 3 meetings. Team, my father's house, release me. Date, 15th and 16th December 2017. Time, Friday 15th, 4 p.m. only. Saturday 16th, 7 a.m. and 4 p.m. Venue, Okotiebo Grammar School, McPherson Road by Reclamation Junction, Sapler Delta State, Nigeria. Your host, Apostle Michael Akpo. Sapler City Crusade, one encounter with God.
No matter the bigness of your problem, your God will still make a way.
Change shall be far. Join us at the Palace of God Bible Church with your own Apostle Michael Akpo.
If they are not a matter for your family, you will break the yoke today. If they are not a get money for your family, you go break the yoke today. If they are not a go abroad for your family, you go break the yoke today. If they don't buy car for your family, you go break the yoke today. If they don't build houses for your family, you go break the yoke today. If they don't carry piggy for your family, Holy Ghost!
Worship with us every Tuesday 10 a.m. Thursdays 3 p.m. Every second Friday, all night prayer 10 p.m. The dawn. Venue. Old District, off PTI Road, opposite Link Up Filling Station, Efro Warri, Delta State, Nigeria. God bless you. Join us.
It's a season where you put your best, you sow seeds, you fast, you pray. Men of God, join you in prayer yet. There is no answer. The Lord told me that some of them have overstayed their wilderness season. It's a prolonged season. When it's too long, people will start dying. Are you sure you are hearing what I'm saying? Am I making sense to somebody? The Bible says, God said to Abraham, your great-grandchildren will stay 400 years in a strange land. That means they will be in dry season for 400 years. That means they will be in the wilderness for 400 years. When it got to 400 years, there was no complaint. But when it got to 430, the Bible said they cried out. When you stay too long in that wilderness area, something will start making you to run from church. When you stay too long for that wilderness season, it will make you to see church members and hide from them. I am here to encourage somebody. Your season is coming to an end. The season of wilderness is coming to an end. The season of pain is coming to an end. Somebody say, Lord, let it come to an end. Please sit down. Sir, it's a season you cannot escape because it must surely come. The only thing I'll pray for you, you will not die there. Do you know what it takes for Jesus to say, Father, why hast thou forsaken me? Remember, it was the same Jesus that said in John chapter 11, thou hearest me always. How come the one that hear always has been forsaken? If you check well, it was because of the wilderness season. When you are in your wilderness season, anything that used to work will never work. Am I making sense to somebody? You are coming out today. The wilderness season is the season of shaking, the season of trouble. You don't even know where it is coming from. You just find out that the whole world is against you. You don't know where it's coming from. That is the season of the wilderness. Can I be free with you? Please, I am not here just to encourage you ordinarily. I have God telling me now for some weeks. He said, go before my people. Enough is enough. Some people are bragging. They are bragging because they think they are better than you. No, it's a season. Are you sure you are hearing me? They are looking down on you. And they thought they are better than you. No, it's a season. They say nothing good can come out of your life. No, it's a season. They are mocking you now that there is nothing to show. Sir, it's a season. Somebody, Allah, it's a season.
It's a season.
Sit down. Let me tell you something. Many years ago, then my first child was still small. We went for a program. And that day, after we closed, a major program, a fasting program. As soon as we closed, around that to 7, I stopped Okada. I said, take me to social place. So I carried my son and I put him at the middle. So we are going. We have not gotten from here to that filling station there. If you see the rain, heavy rain, I've not seen that kind of rain. It just, no sign. It just started. I said, we're behind. If you see the rain, I started shaking. The Okada man said something. He said, sir, I don't know if you continue. I go just die with coal. And I said, Tom, because of my son. That was the first time I saw him in that mood. I saw him. Rigor. Some of you don't know what it's called, Rigor. I saw my son shaking. For the first time, I put my shirt, squeezed his shirt, and started using it to warm him. And I cried out immediately. God, hear me, give me a car. And I was thinking, after 5 days, God will answer. God gave me answer immediately. He said, my son, your time has not come. You are still in the wilderness season. Now the guy is grown up. We were passing there 2 months ago, 2 years ago. We were passing there 2 years ago, and something happened. Then I was in my Range Rover Sport where we were going. He said, Papa! I said, what? He said, I remember this spot. This was where that cold came. I said, you still remember what happened many years ago? He said, I can never forget. But I am no longer in that wilderness season. I have climbed to another level. When I turn, there is testimony. Am I making sense to somebody? I came to push you into your own testimony. I came to push you into your place of celebration. You can shout a lot of me, you are the one I just spoke. See that? When he said so, tears came out from my eyes. That is, he still remembered. After many years. Don't envy anybody. That they are in front of you is not a sign they are better than you. It's their turn. In destiny is Turn by Turn Nigeria Limited. You may be ready today. It's your turn. God is preparing me. Am I making sense to somebody? You are coming out of trouble. Shout the Lord. Please sit down, no time. Please, smile, look at somebody. If the person not smile, tell her, say smile. If the person not smile, tell her, say, don't use your own to rub my own. Are you sure you are looking at somebody? Look at the person, say smile. Not use your own, rub my own. Because after this service, as you sit down near me, so as I won't stand up, leave you now. That's how I go, I can't leave you. Am I talking to somebody at all? Without wasting time, let me go back to where we read from. Before I read 2 Kings chapter 7, verse 1 and verse 2, let me go back to chapter 6. The Bible said there was a famine in the land. A very terrible famine. This was a land that was flowing with milk and honey. Is it true? This was a land that was standing out. But how come the same land that was standing out, there was a strong famine? It was so bad that the Bible says they start eating their children. If you go to verse 26 of that 2 Kings chapter 6, you will see it there. Where they bore a child and ate the child. It was so bad. The Bible says they sold the dung of a dove, not the full dung. The word dung means the excreta of a dove. How many of you know the excreta of a dove is very small? Is it true? But the Bible says they will share it to 4 parts and sell it for 5 silver. It was that bad. It was that bad that no mosquito was passing. It was that bad that they started boiling cockroach. There was no food to eat. Was it that God was not there? No. It was the season of what? Of the wilderness. It was so bad that the king said, let us go and kill the prophets. And the Bible says they started the journey. When they got close, God said to the prophet, the king is coming. and they are coming to cut off your head. He said as soon as the messenger will enter, he will follow. But thank God for a sharp seer. You go see. He said while he was discussing with the elders, lock the door. That evil king is coming. To be frank with you, he got to a place. When they met, the king started complaining. He said, nothing is working. Everything is going down. He said of the prophet to be sober, he laughed. The king said, why are you laughing? He looked at the king and he said, thus saith the Lord, by this time tomorrow, Allah tomorrow, a bag of fine flour will be sold for one shekel. Remember, even the dung of a dove was not sold like that. It's hard that we buy things very cheap. Everything tomorrow, people will be looking for who we buy. They will not buy. As soon as the prophet said so, the Bible says the PA to the king made a statement. He said, even if God opened the window of heaven, it's not possible. When a man is in his wilderness experience or season, even when God is talking, he will not hear. The Bible says, he stood and said, prophet, this thing you said now is a lie. Nobody has confronted you before. As the PA, I confront you. Even if the king will not confront you, I confront you. And I like what Elisha did. He smiled back. Since you are the one bold to talk, you will see it. You will not eat from it. Are you sure you are hearing me? Since you are the one that is bold, even the king was not bold enough to say so. There are some of you looking at me now. You follow mighty men to places. You think they cannot talk. They are wise. You are not to say what you are not supposed to say, because they know what we follow it. Are you sure you are hearing me? The king that was supposed to talk did not say anything. It was the PA that made a statement. He said, even if God opened the window of heaven, nothing will happen. But I like the prophet. He has bad mouth. He said, I don't know, but something is telling me that tomorrow you will see, you will not eat from meat. Are you sure you are hearing what I'm saying? As soon as the man said it, heaven moved immediately, because it was recorded down. There was no food in the land. There was no water in the land. Are you sure you are hearing me? Come, this man is saying so. They said, this is where we will make him know he's a fake prophet. And the Bible said something that touched me. If you go to verse 4, the Bible said, that night, Allah, that night, everything has time and season. In Psalm 30, verse 5, he said, weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Everything has expiry date. Are you sure you are hearing what I'm saying? The Bible said that very night they gathered four leprous men and they made some statement that touched me. They said, we are hungry. If we stay here, we will die. If we enter the city, we will also die. We know there is no food in the city. Let's go to the camp of our enemies. If they spare us, thank God. If they kill us, thank God. And the four agree, not knowing God was in the matter. As soon as these four leprous men enter the camp, from afar, God tied something around their waist, and they were not aware.
When they do like this, when the first one did like this, something shook in heaven. When the second one did like this, there was another thing that shook. When the third one did like this, there was earthquake from heaven. And the captain said something. Let us escape. The noise we are hearing is the noise of mighty men. They have gone to hire more armies. But remember, it was only four people. When they got there, the Bible said there was nobody there. That night, they went around the camp. They never knew it was prophecy that was working. Are you sure you're hearing me? Poor men that had no food. The Bible said they entered the camp. They began to pack goats. They went to hit them. They came back. They carried food items. They went to hit them. They came back. They took money. They went to eat them. One said, I'm not a billionaire. If we live like this, it's not good. Let us go to the city and inform them. And this thing I am telling you now, by this time, is a taboo for a leprous man to enter the city. By this time, it's abomination, because a leprous man does not enter the city. When a man has the spirit of leprosy, they bundle him out of the city. But for the first time, because of evidence, leprous man enter the city. You are about to enter the city. You are about to enter the city.
Your son went to call you. Come. Say, sir, why did you send for me?
Sir, why did you send for me?
The Lord is telling me to pray for you. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 days to live.
God forbid.
Say, explain.
Explain, sir.
I see your son. I see him carry knife and stabbed you here.
God forbid.
Because I don't understand. There was a time he came to fight your mom.
Yes, sir.
And you. Eh? And he fought you too.
Yes, sir.
Your younger brother.
Yes, sir.
I saw a carried knife and stabbed your mom here. Ouch! The spirit controlling him. That spirit died. Only spirit that wants your children to kill you.
Yeah.
In the name that's above every other name.
Yeah.
The spirit died. Sit down. In case that your first time to come here, I know they take a goofy to see. If I won't see, I shall judge the talk. Hey, Hagotan!
Apostle Michael Akpo, Storm Yenagwa, by your South State with a two-day crusade. Team Father, disappoint my enemy.
Inside the cage, your house, the same ministry will not be sweet. You are finding it problems.
Yes,
problems.
Sir. Yes, yes,
problems.
Sir. Yes, sir.
The more you pray, the more they attack you.
Yes, sir.
In the dream.
Yes, sir.
They attack your prayer life.
Yes, sir.
Can I be free with you?
Yes, sir.
Stretch your hand up. Power. Stand up. Stand up. Stand up. Stand up. How long have you been coming here?
I came today.
This is the first time?
Yes, sir.
So you are not here our latest.
No,
sir. So tell me your latest.
Sir.
So tell me your latest.
Tell me your latest.
Rafa Gauthier.
Date 1st and 2nd December 2017. Time Friday 1st 4 p.m. Saturday 2nd 7 a.m. and 4 p.m.
Venue Pansia School Fit, opposite Vegas, Pansia Yenagua, Bayo South State, Nigeria.
Yenagua, Bayo South State, Nigeria.
2097
is coming. Unusual Grace stormed the land of Sapler with a 2-day crusade. 2 days, 3 meetings. Team, my father's house, release me. Date 15th and 16th December 2017. Time Friday 15th 4 p.m. only. Saturday 16th 7 a.m. and 4 p.m. Venue Okotiebo Grammar School, McPherson Road by Reclamation Junction, Sapler Delta State, Nigeria. Your host, Apostle Michael Akpo, Sapler City Crusade, One Encounter with God.